appreciating Moshida. Imagine Mazeke Tede, Regalabalaba, Moshike Tede, make Regale Moshida. If it's not alive, my repale bosh me zekete, me brekele boshida. What will I happen to me? What will I happen to you? Moshekete yederebo, blessing Moshida. Gazeke zelede, me zekeze, he suffered Moshida. For your sake, for my sake, Moshekete yabalaba, appreciating Moshida. Regalabalaba, for that post help, Moshete yegalabalaba. Mazete brekalaba, mezete brekalabalaba, mezete brekalabalaba, mezete brekale Moshida yaba. Mazete brekalabalaba, mezete suffered Moshida, so he can receive all glorification. Moshete tayabalaba, mazete tayaba brekalabalaba, mazete yedelele, mazete zete, ma brekalabo, mezete brekalabalaba. Appreciate you for the peace that you brought, Moshida. Appreciate you, Moshe Ketaya Balabalaba. Mazze Ketaya Balaba. Me Bregalaba. Appreciate you for the differences. Me Bregalabo. Mazze Bregalaba. Deep Magregale Moshida. Magre. Think deep Moshida. Mazze Bregalabalabalaba. Mazze Ketaya Balabalaba. Mazze Bregale Moshida. Magregalabalabalaba. Mazoxo prekele bos meze keteye delede me prekele boshi keteye yalabalaba maze keteye yale bos maze kezele bo ma prekalabalaba prekele bosh maze tebalaba ma prekele bosh maze keteye delede appreciating Moshida especially for today ma prekalabosh maze te ma prekalaba Lord I appreciate you Lord Moshida for the redemption, ma brekalaba, Lord, I thank you, Lord. Ma brekele boshida, gazelede, ma brekele boshida, gazelede, alobolobo, appreciate his blood, ma brekalabalaba, ma brekalaba, without that blood, moshidelede, ma zikoto, ma zukoto, lobolobo, me brekele boshida, gazelede, regalebo, the deal is not done, moshida. Bless him. Ma prekele boshida yagalaba. Ma zete prekele dede prekalabalaba. He's alive. Moshida yagalabalaba. I'm alive. Moshekete yedede dede. Ma sekete yedaliba prekele bosh. Ma zekeze prekalabalaba. Ma prekele boshida. Gazeketa yabalaba. Ma prekalabalaba. He says in his name Moshida. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, Moshida. When ye are gathered like this, Moshida yaba. No, there's no distance in the spirit, Moshida. Ma prekalaba. And my spirit, Moshida. With the power, Moshida. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, Moshida yabalaba. Ma prekalabo. Ma zeze. In his name, Moshida. Ma prekalaba. Moshida. Ma prekele Moshida. Ganze ketelele. Ma prekalabalaba. In his presence, Moshida. Ma prekalabalaba. In his authority. Ma prekelelelele. Ma prekelelelele. Ma prekalabalaba. Moshida ketelelele. Ma zekeze prekelelelele. Prekalabalaba. Ma zuzo prekele bosh. Ma zeketa yabalaba. Ma prekoshida. Ma zekeze prekelelele. Ma prekalaba. More of your purpose, Lord, Moshida dede. Show us again, ma prekalabalaba. Ma zekeze prekoshida kete yedalaba. Ma zekeze prekalaba. Explain yourself more. In your word, Moshida. Again, ma prekele bosh. Ma zekeze. Ma prekalabalaba. Prekalabalaba. Ma zozo prekele bosh. Ma zekete yedede. Ma zekete yedede. Ma zekete yedede. Ma prekele bosh. Ma zekete yedede. Ma prekele bosh. Ga zekede. It's only him that can open your understanding again. Ma prekele bosh. Ga zekede. Begin to tell yourself, Lord, I prepare myself again. Ma shekete yedede. Ma prekele bosh. Ma zekede. Ma prekele balaba. Ma prekele bosh. Ma zekede. Ma prekele balaba. Lord, I align myself, Moshida. for your purpose. Mo shake it yede, ma prekele yede, ma regala balaba. There is a reason. Mo shake it for everything. Me prekele mo shida. Father, ma zedze more of your reason for today. Ma prekele mo shida. Legala galaba until mo shida ya balaba. Me prekele mo shida. He opened ma regala ba until he opens your eyes. Mo shida of your understanding. Ma prekele mo shida. His purpose mo shida yede. May not be known Moshida unto you, Moshida, Lord Mokru Balaba, Regele Moshida, Gaze Yede, Maze Ketaya Balaba, then said one to another, Makrekalaba, then Regalaba, did not our heart burn Moshida within us, Moshida, when he talked Moshida, Father Makru Balaba, as we are going to talk again to us, Moshida, this morning, Makrekalaba, by the power of your resurrection, Masekete, open the eyes of my understanding, Makrekelebo, Mashekede, you are the one yesterday, you are the one today, you are the one forever, Mosheketa Yaba, Regalebo, Maseketa Yabalaba, Me Regalibos, Mosuzolo, Makrekalabalaba, Makrekelebo Shida, then open in your understanding, Makrubalaba, that you might understand the scriptures, Moshida, Father Mosheketa Yabalaba, in the name of your Makre, of our Lord Jesus Christ, Moshida. We pray again, Makru Moshida. Open our eyes, Moshida Yabalabalaba. Open our eyes, Moshida, especially Mokru Balaba. In this end time, Mosheketa Yabalabalaba. Mazekete Yede, Makru Moshida. Mazete Pru Balaba. By ourselves, Moshida. We cannot do it by our own ability, Moshida. But by your spirit, Mosheketa Yabalaba. Open our eyes of understanding. Mokru Balaba. Mazekete yede, Mazekete yede, Mazekete yede, Ma pregale boshida, Mazete pregale bosh, Mazekete yabalaba, Mazete pregale bolobo, Me pregale boshida, Ma pregale balaba, Me pregale boshida, the entrance of thy words, Moshida, give a light, Ma pregale balaba, He giveth understanding unto the simple, Ma pregale boshida, open my eyes, Lord Moshida, Me pregale balaba, Regala balaba, open the corner, Moshekete yede, Masekete yede of my heart, Moshida, Mazuzo, regala balaba, me regale Moshida, Gazekelebo, talk to me, Lord Moshida, cause your word to come expressly, Ma regale Moshida, Gazekete yabalaba, Ma regale de, Ma regale de, Ma regala balaba, Moshekete yabalaba, Ma jekete yede, Ma jekete yede, Ma jekete yede. Ma jekete yede, ma pregale Moshida, go zotolobo, ma pregala balaba, pregala balaba, mo jekete yede, pregala ba, ma pregale Moshida, gazedo, I position myself, Lord, begin to tell yourself, Moshida, Lord, I position myself, mo jekete yaba, for your downloading, mo brrrr, balaba, me jekete yede, pregala ba, for your impartation, ma jekete yede, Masekete yabalabalaba, Masekete, ma pregele Moshida, Masekzekzek regala balabalaba, Masekete yede, Masekete yede, Masekete yede, Masekete yede bolobo, ma pregale Mosh, Masekete yede, Masekete yede yaba, ma pru Moshida, Kazekata yaba, me pregala balaba, pregala ba, when the spirit of the Lord is Moshida, there is liberty, me pregala balaba, pregale Moshida. Holy Ghost, Moshida, Moshida, we ask Lord Moshida, the unknown aspect, Lord, Mekregale Moshida, Gazeketa Yaba, we start through every Moshida, Mazoko Tololo, Mekregalaba, Makru Moshida, Mekzeze, Mazeze, Mazeze, Mekregalabalaba, Mazeze, Regale Moshida, Gazede, but as I have not seen Moshida, Mekregalaba, what is written, Moshida, Mekru. Your eyes have not seen Moshida, nor yet heard Mokregalaba, neither have entered into the heart of man Moshida. The things Moshida, which God has prepared for them that love him Moshida. I believe you love him, that's why you are on brand Moshida. Mokregalaba, Mokregale Moshida, Gazekete. Mazuko Tolobo, Pregalaba, Mazete, Pregalabalaba, Me Pregalabalaba, Krukoshida. For God has revealed them unto us by Spirit. spirit, more prove alaba, make break alaba, for the spirit suggests all things more shield. Yet the deep things of God, more prove alaba, my jacket sayaba, my jacket sayelebo, my break alebosh, my zuzo break alebosh, my zeket ze prove alaba, make zigze prove jetayaba, prove shield, my zuzo break alebosh, my zozo break alebosh, my prove shield, make zigze break alaba. The veils, Moshe Ketayaba, may break Alabalaba, thou not allow Moshida to see him again, Makru Balaba, begin to tell yourself, Moshida, may break Alebo, Shmasia Ketayabo, may break Alaba, Lord, anoint my eyes with the eyes of Moshida, so I can see you clearly, Moshida Yabalaba, Mazekeze, Pru Balaba, so that will be Moshe Tayede, one on one, may Pru Balaba encounter. Enough is enough, Moshe Ketaye Dalabalaba, Moshe Ketaye Dede, Regalebo, Mazeze, Regalabalaba, Moshe Ketaye Debo, that's time, Moshida, and chance for everybody, Mokru Balaba, on this earth, Moshida, Lord Mokru Balaba, why am this Makra, on this earth, Moshida, make Regalede, Regalede, Moshe Ketaye, Makru Moshida, I ask for more grace, make Shekatayaba to be in the spirit, at all time, Moshida, make Zete break, la 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 la. I will not allow Moshida, this thoughtfulness, Moshida, the carelessness, Moshida of this world, Regalaba to take me over. Makzozo break, la 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 la. Make Zete break, Moshida, make Regalaba la 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 la. Makruba la la la. Makruba Moshida, Kakelele, Makruba la la. Now the Lord is that spirit, Moshida, Makruba la la. And when the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Makregele, Moshida, Makrega la la la. Moshe Ketaya Balaba, Krega la la. Make Zete, Kregele, Makzete, Krega la 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 la. Makzekeze, Krega la la. We are not asking in Moshida for butter or for bread, Moshida. We are seeking the Makreba, his interest, first Moshida. He says, seeking first the kingdom of God, Moshida. He knows you, Mokru Balaba, Mekregele Moshida, Makangalabosh, Mazete, 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 Mekregalebosh, Mazete, Makregalaba, Spirit of God, take me over, Lord. Me break the bush, man. Zede, me break Balaba, break the day. I was the spirit on the Lord's day, Moshida, and I heard behind me, Moshida, a great voice, ability to hear you clearly. Me break the bush, man. Zede, me break Balaba. Is more than gold, is more than silver. Moshida, get the day. Me break Moshida. Awareness, Lord. Man, Zede, break Balaba, Balaba. Me break Balaba, Balaba, Balaba. Me break Moshida. Me Zede, break Moshida. As we are praying, Moshida, we are connecting ourselves, Mekru Moshida, to the Father's heart, Moshida. It's him that we're able to do, Moshida, what you cannot do, Moshida, Yabalaba. This is the life, Moshida, we've chosen, Moshida, the life of the spirit, Wherefore, Moshida, Moshindere, my beloved Moshinda, Makregelede, as we are always Moshinda. Obey me, Moshinda, Nebregalaba, not as my presence alone, Moshinda, Nebregalaba, Nebregelede, Makre Moshinda, but much more Galaba, Makregalaba, but now much more Balaba, Makre Moshinda, in my absence, Moshinda, walk out, Moshinda, your salvation, Makzeketa Yabalaba, Nebregalaba. With fear and trembling, my prayer Moshinda, Gazette, my prayer Moshinda, for it is God Moshinda, which work is you both to do, Mokrubalaba, and prayer Moshinda. You cannot do it, Mokrubalaba. That is why Moshinda, we must depend Mokrubalaba absolutely, my prayer upon him Moshinda. As you are praying, Moshinda, you are opening the door of your heart. You are telling me, Moshinda, I'm here, Lord, Moshinda. If any man open, Moshinda, if any man open his heart, Moshinda, Lord Moshinda, I open Lord Moshinda, my faculty again, Moshinda, I will not frustrate Moshinda, the grace of God, Let's begin to pray for the servant of God, Moshinda. The anointing Makregalaba on Friday, Moshinda, is not enough, Moshinda. Father Moshinda, Makregalaba, we lift him up, Moshinda, before you again this morning. Makregalaba, with whom your hand, Mokrebaba, will be established. Mokregalaba, fill him up. More than before, Moshinda, anointing Moshinda. Makregalaba, Moshinda, relevant works, word of knowledge, word of wisdom, interaction, with angels, answer from Father's heart, Moshinda. Father, we ask for him, Moshinda. We ask for boldness. It's not by might, Moshinda. It's not by power, but by spirit, Moshinda. Lord, we ask for inspiration from Father's heart, Moshinda. All scriptures, is given by inspiration of God. Relevant words, example, illustration, all scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Anointing, Lord. That's body shall be taken away from one that shoulder. Mac regala balaba and mac regale moshida and yoke moshida from one that neck moshida and yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Mac regala balaba, mac seketeye dede, 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 mac regala bolobo, mac sekeze bru moshida, mac seketeye balaba. And Lord, behold, they are threatening Moshida. And grant unto thy servant Moshida with all boldness. Moshida, you will deliver total counsel of God again. Ma pregale Moshida. Ma zete regalada. Ma pregalada. Regalada. Ma sheketeye. Regalada. Ma kuzuzo. Regalada. Ma pregale Moshida. That zete. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with Holy Ghost Moshida. And with power. Pregalada. Who went about doing good for Krubalaba in Moshida on our oppressed Moshida of the devil, for God was within Moshida. Makregalabalaba, Makregalaboshi, Mazete, Regalade, Majekete, Majekete, Makregalabalaba, Mazeketeyaba, and all witnesses, Moshida, and we are all witnesses of things which Mokura did Mokrubalaba, both in land of the Jews, Moshida, Mekrubalaba, and Jerusalem, Mekuru Balaba, who they slew Moshida, and hang on a tree, Mosheketa Yabalaba, Mekregalaba, and he taught Makregalaba, Makregalaba, Maseketa, in God raised up Moshida, Regalaba, he taught them Moshida, Apregalabalaba, and show him Mokuru Balaba openly, Mapalabalaba, Mesekese, Ru Moshida, Mesekese, Regalabalaba, Maseketa Yabalaba, Mapru. We are not going to see different. If you do Moshida, Moshida is the same day. Mekregalaba is the same yesterday. Mokrubalaba, Moshekete today and forever. Moshida, confirm your word with signs and wonders, Lord. Moshekete yabalaba, Mekregalebosh, Masekete yedededede, Masekete yedededede, Masekete yedededede, Mapalabalabalabalaba, Kregalededede, Masekete yedede. Lord, we ask for impartation. Masekete yedalabo, Mapalabalabalaba, Masekete yedededede. Masekete, we are still praying for your Makrebalaba, Masekete, the servant of God, Moshida, Makregalede, Mekregalaba, for our gospel came not only Moshida, Mekrubalaba unto you, Mokregalaba, for our Makregale Moshida, Makregalede, Masekete, Masekete, for our gospel came not unto you, Moshida, in word only, Makregalaba, but also in power, Moshekete, and the Holy Ghost, Moshida, and much assurance. Mo prekala balaba, ma zozo prekele dede, ma shekete ye dede, ma shekete ye dede, ma shekete ye dede, ma prekala balaba, ma shekete ye dede, ma zozo proboshida, ma shekete ye dede, ma prekala balaba, mo shika toyo dodo, mo shika koro dodo, mo shika prekala balaba, mo shekete ye dede, it will come with the fullness, mo shida of the gospel, mo shida this morning, ma. I'm a Krubalaba Matsula from Father's heart, Moshekete Yabalaba, Mekrubalaba, Matsu him afresh, Mokrubalaba, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Mapregalabalaba, Mapregalabalaba, Moshekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, Majekete Yede, he says, Moshida, I will give you pastors, Moshida, according to my heart, we shall feed you, Moshida, with the knowledge I understand. Let's begin to bless him. Moshe Ketayabalaba. Let's adore him. I pray Galaba. He says, we are two. Or three are gathered together. We are more than two. We are more than three. Moshe Ketay. My pray Galada. Appreciate him. My pray Galaba. Appreciate him. My pray Galaba. He says, call unto me, Moshe. I will show you great and mighty things. My pray Galaba. Appreciate him. My pray for another dimension. My Zeketay. My pray Moshe. God Zeketay. My pray.
Sacrificing himself. Let's thank him for going to the cross. If not for him, what would we be today? Father, we worship you. Jesus, we thank you. We worship you. We give you thanks. We give you glory. What will Christianity be like without Jesus? What will the world be without Jesus? We thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you. Lord, we give you thanks. We give you glory. Tani wo tu figubu obe. Father, in the name of Jesus. Jesus, we thank you. We give you thanks, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you all adoration. Thank you, Lord. We thank thank you, Lord. We thank you because he is risen. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for the ministry of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father. We give you thanks. We give you glory. We give you all the honor, all adoration. We say, may your name alone be highly exalted, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. We give you thanks. We give you glory. We give you all the honor, all adoration. Thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. up your voice and sing the song unto the Maker. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. Lift your hands and ini baba to you baba Lord and ini baba to baba live la la and ini baba to you baba ini baba to baba live ya da ba Eyini Baba, Eyini Baba, oh,
Baba,
la la ga da 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 da, Oba Tom Shom Teni Koleshi, Uru Koreti Ni.
Let's bless and adore His holy, silly name. It's too good, it's too beautiful, it's too awesome, it's too pleasant, it's powerful. And let's thank Him because of the rejoicing of this day. It's Easter period again. This is Easter Sunday. Our Lord is remembered to be risen from the dead. A significant thing. Something that brought effect and signature upon our lives and upon our destinies. Let's bless Him for this. The Bible says, who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is Christ. It is God that justifies. Let me say to you, who is it that condemned? It is Christ that died. Let me say to you, and it's risen again. It has marked the beginning of the hand of condemnation in the life of the one that has professed Jesus to be the Lord. Blessing. Everybody testifies, you are good, Baba. You are good, Jehovah. You are good. Yeah. Everybody testifies, you are good. Oh, you are good, Jehovah. You are good. Yeah. Everybody testifies. You are good, you are so good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Everybody testifies, you are good. You are good, Jehovah, you are good. Father, we bless you, we adore you, we honor you, we lift your name on high.
Thank you for this awesome privilege of lifting our voices to worship you this morning again. Thank you for the awesome privilege of celebrating the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you because he suffered. We bless and appreciate your holy name. Honor and majesty to you. Just wave your hands to him. Just wave your hands to him. Just wave your hands to him. Le manzato nabia. Ore re ni latima fugu folua. Ore re ni latima fugu fun Jesu. Ore re ni latima ni oruko re baba. Latima ni oruko re oga ogu. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have worshipped. I said, in Jesus' name we have worshipped.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I welcome everybody to this morning's broadcast again. Thank God. This is the Safe Havens Christian Church online streaming. And since there is a lockdown, we are broadcasting from home. We are calling the home church. And we have branches in different places, the different houses of the different members of the church, and anybody that is going to link up with us. If you're not a member of the church and you're watching this, we welcome you and we trust God that you're going to have a wonderful time. As your heart is open unto what God is going to be doing for you, great things are going to happen to you. Beautiful experiences are going to come to you. Why? Because the Lord is here and his spirit is amazed. So, saved members, I say it again, I am missing you. And honestly, I don't want them. So that we're going to see church this week by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Then I want to wish everybody a happy Easter celebration. What a beautiful time. What a beautiful experience. And based on that, I want to show us one or two things as I take on my message. It's going to be in fragments of about three parts, but then we trust God that some beautiful things are going to happen. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 8, very quickly. Let me show us one or two significance of the celebration of Easter. Hallelujah. What Jesus did for humanity took different steps. Jesus was first of all arrested. In fact, not just arrested, he was alleged at the time. He was betrayed by another person. He was arrested. He was tried. He was condemned to death. He went through the process of death and was there in the belly of hell for 3 days. And on the third day, he rose from the dead. He didn't just rise from the dead. The Bible says dead saints in Jerusalem had their tombs open and they came out of the tomb and he signaled the liberty for anything that is dead. By virtue of the resurrection of Jesus, deadness was brought to an end. And Ephesians chapter 4 corroborated that the Bible says, when the Bible says he led captivity captive and he set men free. Then, after staying about a few days on earth, after his resurrection, he ascended to heaven to sit down on the right hand of the Father. Each of the different steps is significant and they have a lot of things they do in the life of the believer. And the believer himself must be aware of what these different things stand for. I may not have the luxury of preaching an Easter message. That is not what God has impressed upon my heart strongly. But then, there is one or two things so significant about Easter that I want you to see, I want you to know, I want you to be aware of. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of Romans chapter 8. Libra Mans Antonio Kuda 30. Hallelujah. It says, moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called, and whom he called, them he also justified, and whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we then say to these things? Now, if you're a member of the church, I've elaborated on this for some time. The spectrum of life, I called it. In verse 31, what shall we say then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Now listen, we see that the beginning of nothing, no one, no system, no humanity, no human being, no work of veil, no structures, the beginning of them not being able to stand against the child of God is that God sent his only begotten Son. He delivered him up for us all. Let me connect it again. What shall we then say to these things? 31. If God be for us, who can be against us? So we can conclude that God decided to give Jesus to us so that nothing and nobody can be able to stand before or against the child of God. That is elaborate. But then because of time, I'm just looking at one or two things here. Verse 32, he that spared not his own son, but delivered him all for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justified. And the justification of humanity and mankind, especially the ones that have given their life to Jesus, came as a result of the fact that they accepted the sacrifice of the only one Son of God, Jesus Christ, then, before we began to become sons through him. The Bible says, verse 34, who is it that condemned? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, and who also maketh intercession for us. Can you see that? Who is it that condemned? It is Christ that died. The answer to who is it that condemned is the death of Christ. So the death of Christ actually brought about a lot of things that are extremely significant. Mankind has to be condemned to death. Sin is the reason why mankind has to be condemned to hell. But then Jesus Christ died. The Bible says he bore the sin of humanity upon himself. When John the Baptist was going to introduce him to his disciples, he said, behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the whole world. The Bible says, in the book of Zechariah chapter 3, the scripture tells us that he was wearing filthy garments on himself, which is supposed to be the filthy garments of the sin of humanity. But then he was stripped of that filthy garment and another garment of righteousness was put on him. So he dealt with sin that's supposed to be making humanity to be judged and condemned to sin, condemned to death, eternal death, which is supposed to take place in hell. If you're listening to me this morning and you have not given your life to Jesus, it is too significant. It is not righteous practices that is going to take somebody to heaven or hell primarily. The first ticket you have to get is giving your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. In John chapter 14, he went ahead to say, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And he went ahead to say, the place I'm going, you know, and the way to that place, you know. Then one of the disciples asked him, where are you going and where is the way to it? They have told you before, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me. Now, that is extremely significant. That's the first step you have to take if you are going to be free from this condemnation that's supposed to sentence you to hell. Listen, it doesn't matter how righteous you can be. It doesn't matter even if you never committed a sin before in your life, and it is not possible. Upon all your carefulness, it's not possible for you not to have committed a sin. Now, it doesn't matter how much you do it, that the rate of sinning is low compared with the rate that some other people are sinning. The Bible says, if you have not believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, it is the way God has chosen. It is the way God has ordained. Nobody can argue against it or argue with it. Now, so if you think it's your righteous work that is going to take you to heaven, no, it's not going to work. Why? Because you are still going to be condemned to death. And listen, when you are condemned like that, it gives the devil the chance and the leverage to be able to harass you and oppress you now. He says, what shall we then say to this thing? If God be for us, who can be against us? The hordes of hell are going to be against you successfully because you are condemned to death. Now, so why don't you receive the means to justification by accepting Jesus to be your Lord? You have had a lot of preachings about him. Yes, I know. But you may not have consciously and significantly confessed him to be your Lord and Savior. And I want you to be very conscious. There are too many voices in this world now. If you read Revelation chapter 13, the Bible is talking about the manifestation of Antichrist, two different beasts in those days. One of the things that those spirits will be doing
or the Antichrist will be doing is to be using words, blasphemous words against God, and to be displaying great power. But then 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 has told us that the Antichrist is still being restrained, I believe, by the Holy Ghost, so that he has not come to full manifestation. And the rapture of the church is going to take place before there is a full manifestation of the Antichrist. But then 1 John chapter 4, chapters 3 and 4, again tell us that there are already workers, agents of the Antichrist that are moving about now. It's amazing the rate at which a lot of people who feel they are celebrities and who are vocal, who are great orators, are speaking blasphemous things against God. There are some that are atheists, there are some that believe they are not even atheists, they believe in God. But then they attack you and what is supposed to lead you to justification in life by condemning everything that has to do with church, condemning servants of God that are supposed to be the agents of your agent of the delivery of the virtues of God to you so that it can lead you to heaven. Now, if you're a young man especially, or a young woman especially, because one of the things that the devil uses for the younger generation is to corrupt their mind. The people in the first world sinned against God and God wiped them up with the use of the flood in those days. The Bible says, "No, I found grace in the sight of the Lord." But then in chapter 8, after the old thing has subsided and Noah began a new life with his family, the scripture tells us something. That God promised Noah that he was not going to destroy the earth with water or flooding because the imagination of a man has been evil from the day of his youth. So one of the things the devil does for the people of younger generation is to begin to corrupt their imaginations. So they begin to hear all manners of things because there is a level of curiosity inside them. So he begins to bombard their minds with a lot of positions that are anti-God, that are anti-church, that are anti-servant of God. And some of them are not wise enough to even scrutinize or even be cautious or careful. They just go with such insinuations or things that are spreaded about, and before you know it, they are caught in the web that the devil wants them to get into. Now listen, if you are not free from sin, then you must know that you need God. If you are not free from sin, then you must know you need the anointing on servants of God. If the battles of life are troubling you, then you must know that someone is deceiving you. It's the Antichrist that is showing up one way or the other. So I go back to the original thought. Now, the death of Jesus did something significant. He made sin to die, and everything that came with sin died. Then the next thing, Jesus Christ was raised from the dead to bring about the resurrection of the things that are dead inside a man that should be living. For instance, the spirit of man was dead in the Garden of Eden. When Adam and Eve decided to disobey God by eating the fruit he commanded them not to eat, he snuffed out the life inside their spirit man, and the spirit, and they could only be living from the mental realm and from the specific physical realm. But by virtue of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, he announced the giving of life to the same spirit man that God ordained should be controlling the affairs of the human life. May I tell you this? It doesn't matter your intellectual capacity. That is not the definition of your life, really. The real you is the spirit. When a man dies, it is the spirit that is terminated, that dies, that gets out of the body. And you see the uselessness of every other thing the moment the man dies. Now listen, it's the spirit that is making the soul that you have, that the extreme mental capacity to be celebrated. It is the spirit that is making your body. If you're a beautiful lady, for instance, that everybody adores you, you are a Miss This, Miss That, beauty pageant winner. Now listen, the moment the spirit leaves the body, it cannot be celebrated any longer. So we must know where the value actually belongs. We must know the actual thing that makes a human. So, but if the spirit of that human has not received the life of God, then life cannot be the way it's supposed to be with God. But the ones that have received the life of God into their spirit, those ones are the ones that are called the children of God, and they stand the chance of being successful in life. They stand the chance of defeating the devil again and again. In my message as I proceed today, I want to show us things that make for the reality of the redemption of man. Now, so if a man now has received the Spirit of God on his inside, he stands the chance, if he has received the life of God on his inside, he stands the chance of making it, the chance of defeating the devil, the chance of excelling, the chance of being victorious, the chance of overcoming at all times. So that is the reason the Bible says
It is Christ that is risen from death. Number two. Number three, the Bible says he's even on the right hand of the Father in heaven making intercession for us. What is that supposed to represent? If there are things that the child of God on his own cannot handle on earth, if they are beyond him, Christ has not stopped ministry. He's there in heaven on the right hand of the Father making intercession, pushing God to intervene on behalf of the child of God, pushing God to release the resources of heaven, angels inclusive, to go and fight on behalf of the child of God that is helpless at a particular time or the other. So listen, in all perspective, we are covered. In all perspective, we are protected. And that is the reason we are celebrating Easter. We are celebrating the fact that Jesus was raised from the dead. Listen, he was not raised from the dead to be living on earth again. He was raised from the dead to ascend to heaven and to sit on the right hand of the Father. He is not the only one sitting there. He took us with him and we're sitting there with him to dispense the authority of God. That is the reason the Bible will tell us in the book of Ephesians chapter 1, I think from verse 16. And one of the things that the Apostle Paul was praying for that church is this. He said, I'm praying for you that the eyes of your understanding will be enlightened, that you will know the hope of his calling, number one, the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, number two, and the exceeding greatness of the power that is available for your use, to you for your use as a child of God. So why do we have such power? Because Jesus raised us to begin to dwell and sit in the place of power, just like he's sitting in the place of power. Our bodies may be on earth. Listen, he says, I bow my knees unto the Father. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and on earth. Now listen, that simply tells you, I have relatives abroad. They are part of my family. They are part of my blood, but they don't live in Nigeria. And I'm sure many of you listening to me may have such experience as well, that you have relatives that are distant from you, but they bear the same name, you share the same blood, you have affinity and affection for each other. Now, because your locations are different, definitely your experiences are going to be different. The government that is ruling Nigeria is different from the government ruling America. It's different from the government ruling Germany. Now, listen, one government seems to be better than the other, and that would determine the experiences of the people that are under such government and rulership. Some governments lack power. Some governments are powerful. Some governments have the interest of the populace at heart. Some seem to not to have the interest of the populace at heart. Some of the communities or some of the nations are very developed. Some are called developing countries. And that is going to determine the quality of life that the people in such places are having. So the same thing. There are members of the family that are in heaven and members of the family of God that are on earth. Our experiences may be different because of the location, but it is the same family. That must be well understood. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So back to Ephesians chapter 1, the scripture tells us that the Apostle Paul was praying for us that we will know the power of God that is available unto us for our use. And honestly, no child of God is helpless in that regard. I want to go into my message today. And we have been talking about the Holy Ghost. Last week, I spoke to us about this from 2 Kings chapter 4. Father, we give you glory and praise. Thank you because you are in absolute control. Hallelujah. I spoke to us from 2 Kings chapter 4, the story of the widow woman who had a pot of oil in her house. And then the small pot of oil that she had in her house was enough to make her run a simple life. But then a greater problem than she imagined came around her. And then she was helpless. And she ran to the man of God and I said, the creditors have come to take my two sons from me and my husband has died. So I have inherited the same debt. Then the man of God asked, what do you have in your house? She said, nothing but a pot of oil. And the man of God told her, go and borrow vessels from your neighbor and do not borrow a few. And when you get into the house, shut the door. Same oil inside the vessels, then tell me what happens afterwards. The Bible says she gathered the vessels like she was instructed, and after that, the scripture says that she was pouring the oil, and she told the son, bring one more vessel, and the son said, there's no more vessel. Then the oil stopped flowing, and I told us the man of God instructed her, go and sell the oil, settle your debt and live on the rest. That is so significant. Now we see that there is a life that can be run by a small measure of the oil, and there is another life that can only be run by a great oil. I said this last week and I want to repeat it again. Indebtedness in life cannot take small measure of oil. Hallelujah. Indebtedness in life cannot take a small measure of oil. It takes a very, very large volume of oil. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now, so if you are here and you have a measure of debt or the other, I would like you to pay attention to everything I'm saying today. Why? Because the whatever problem that the devil brings against the child of God is not his. The main issue in life will be the inadequacy on the part of the child of God to know what to do and to do the needful so that he can always be an overcomer. If there were no men of God that are anointed on earth and the child of God can do what he's supposed to do, every child of God will still have victory. But then there are processes of growth. Somebody doesn't get born again and becomes mature immediately. But the devil will not wait for you to be mature before he begins to attack you. If you watch animal wildlife documentaries, you are going to see that the predators of the wild, most of the times, don't go for mature animals. It's only when they don't have option. If you have a pack of zebra, for instance, you have a pack of giraffe, and some of these animals that are big, if a pride of lion is going to attack, they look for the most vulnerable one, and most of the times, they are the young ones. So those ones cannot run as fast as the mature ones. Those ones are not strong enough to kick back like the mature ones. So the devil is not going to wait for us to be mature before he begins to attack. The smaller we are in Christianity, the younger we are in Christianity, the easier it is for the devil to attack us. And that is the reason God has called men and anointed them to be deliverers unto the ones that are going in Christ. But a time comes when you're expected to grow enough to be able to stand your ground, and that is what maturity fetches you in Christianity. It comes by understanding. It comes by you exposing yourself to the knowledge of the Word of God. It comes by you hearing the preachings of the Word of God. It comes by you meditating on the Word of God, solidifying yourself, developing your spirit man, and making it a match, and more than a match, for any assault that the devil is going to bring. Then when that happens, men will not, or Christians will not be having nightmares again. And when masquerades and the likes come to them in their dreams, they will be the one chasing the masquerade instead of the masquerade chasing them. And when wild animals appear to them in their dreams, they will be the one chasing the wild animals instead of the wild animals chasing them. And when they begin to wrestle with wrong forces in their dreams, they will be the one defeating the wrong forces instead of the wrong forces defeating them. So we must understand this as we proceed in our understanding of how to translate the victory that we have gotten in the Lord Jesus Christ into reality. So things like indebtedness, things like sicknesses and disease may require a greater level of the Spirit of God, because the pot of oil the woman said was in her house represents the measure of the anointing or the energy of the Spirit in that was available unto her. Now, I'm trying to give us a challenge here that we must prepare for the future. And whatever the devil is going to bring, we must prepare for it. There have been people who are doing well in life, and suddenly it was a business downturn that destroyed their life. 25 years after, they have not been able to rise up again. And you begin to hear such people saying, if not for this, if not for this, if not for this, they accepted defeat. It's not supposed to be so for the child of God. The Bible tells us that we must keep our lamps burning. We must keep our lamps burning. And it takes the oil of the Spirit to keep this lamp burning. So that if the devil should attack us at all, he's going to meet more than a match for him by the time he comes around. There are people who are running wonderful and good life. The oil in their life is enough for them to have academic excellence and beautiful life. But the moment the same lady translated into marriage, she began to meet dimensions of challenges that the current level of oil or the level of oil that she used while she was under her parents cannot handle. If somebody told her that she should have built a reserve, probably she would have done. So don't be satisfied with the level of the anointing that you're wielding.
is enough to make you go to work and you take salary, and the salary is enough to pay your children's tuition and the likes and the likes. But a challenge may come in the future that this level of oil is not enough for. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You remember the parable of the 10 virgins as well. The 5 had oil. In fact, the 10 of them had oil. But 5 did not have extra oil. And the 5 that did not have extra oil, the Bible says they were shut away from the place when the bridegroom arrived. The Bible says they were in outer darkness where there was weeping and gnashing of teeth. It simply means when people don't have sufficient oil, weeping and gnashing of teeth will be, or rather, darkness, weeping and gnashing of teeth will be their continual experiences. So if you're a believer now, that for one reason or the other, you are gnashing your teeth, for one reason or the other, you are weeping. It may just be that the problem is that you lack sufficient oil. And if you are not in this situation yet, you must understand that, how will I put it? You must understand that and learn from the example of those virgins that you get an extra oil ahead of time or before the challenges of life begin to face us or face you. Now, let's go to the book of Isaiah chapter 54. I promised I was going to pick up from here last Sunday, and I want to do just that. Isaiah 54. I want to show us a dimension of the spirit that overrides every natural process for productivity, fruitfulness, enlargement, progress, and the like. I give us a very good example. What God has said, for there to be fruitfulness, for there to be enlargement, for humanity, for there to be increase among human beings, God said to Abraham, Adam, and Eve, he said, be fruitful and multiply. But you and I know it was just the blessing of God. That was the blessing of God. In other words, God was putting a sanction upon their life, and nothing shall be able to stop it ordinarily. Now, but it will take the two of them coming together in copulation before that can happen. The man must have to sleep with the woman before they could be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth to subdue it. Now, is there any necessity for multiplication? Is there any beauty in increase? Yes. God gave the land of Canaan to the children of Israel, and he told them that he had given it unto them. And he told Abraham, who was their father, he should walk up and down the land. He crossed it transversely. He went from north to south, from east to west. And God said, as far as you can see, they have I given unto you for a possession, especially for your children that are going to come. But then by the time the children of Israel were delivered from Egypt and they passed through the wilderness and quite a number of them were destroyed there, the handful that remained were going to possess that land. God did not change his mind that because they had reduced the number, he was going to reduce the volume of land that he had allotted to them. But then there was a challenge here. God told them that in the same land that you are going, and I want you to pay attention to this, in the same land that you are going, the land I said is flowing with milk and honey, the land that I said is full of all the natural mineral resources, the land that I said would make you to be wealthy, God told them something. There are beasts in the same land. Now, the fact that you get into the land does not mean the devil has not tried to position his own forces that are going to militate against you. God said, let me now give you a strategy that is going to be helpful to you. Number one, the enemies that are presently occupying the land, don't chase them all at once. Begin to acquire the land little by little, so that it will not happen that by the time you have chased all the enemies away, the beast of the field, that is the agents of darkness, will now multiply against you and they begin to hit you. Just recently, I was watching a wildlife documentary about some predators, and they were talking about the leopard, and now it has killed a lot of people in the leopard and the tiger in India. And serially, every year, they record death of human beings brought about by these animals. Now, some other ones I saw that they said hippopotamus have killed a lot of people.
crocodiles have killed people. Now, these are wild animals, but they ended up killing human beings. And when you look at it critically, most of the times, these animals succeed killing people in places like villages, where the population is not so high, where infrastructural development is not so high. So God now told them, so now, this thing we're seeing or we discerned in this documentary captures the mind of God. He loves his people enough that he doesn't want beasts or wild animals to kill them. So he now said, the only antidote and the only solution you have is for you to multiply and increase. The more you multiply and the more you increase, your chances of overcoming the wild animals will be higher. When you look at wildlife documentaries as well, you are going to discover that they said some animals are fast going into extinction. What is really bringing it about? Poaching. What is really bringing it about? Because human beings are increasing in number and there is a need for them to occupy the same land that these animals are living in. So they begin to chase them back or they begin to kill them. Now, the same way God says, when you multiply in number, you are going to have the capacity to push away these wild animals, kill them or chase them out of the land completely. So that is the reason why there must be increase in the life of the child of God. That is the reason why there must be multiplication in the life of the child of God. God has done what he's supposed to do. He said, be fruitful and multiply. But then we have some situation. As much as God has placed the blessing upon his children like this, as much as he said it unto Adam and Eve, be fruitful and multiply, there are Christian couples that are doing what Adam and Eve did, yet it is not translating into fruitfulness and multiplication. Let's go beyond physical fruitfulness and multiplication now. They're talking about pregnancy, literal pregnancy, and giving birth. Let's look at other aspects of life that require fruitfulness. God has said it. Now put your right hand on your chest and say after me, God has declared upon me that I should be fruitful and multiply. He has blessed me with such blessing and I take it in Jesus' name. Now, in the areas of finances, in the areas of academics, and other areas of life, we have seen where men made the necessary attempt, but it did not turn into multiplication and it did not turn to increase. Don't forget what I said earlier on. Where there is no multiplication and where there is no increase, the chances that the wild beast of life will come against one is high. And don't forget, the language God used is that let the beast of the field multiply against you. That simply means in the kingdom of darkness, multiplication is going on. The forces that the devil is designing against you and I are increasing in number. Let the beasts of the field multiply against you. So it's going to be multiplication versus multiplication. Now, so if a believer is not multiplying, is not increasing, that does not stop the enemy from increasing against him. So he may not be able to match the hassles the enemy is going to bring against him eventually. Talking about fruitfulness and multiplication, God says in Psalm 127, he says, children are the heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. He says, blessed is the man whose quiver is full of these children. As the arrow is in the hand of a mighty man, so are they against his enemy on the day the enemy visits him. That's the man that has children. Each of the arrow represents a child. So if a man has two children and they do well in life, there is a very great chance that he has double chance of defeating his enemy. If a man has three children and they equally do well in life, then the man has triple chance of beating the enemy. If a man has four children and they have done equally well in life, he has a quadruple chance of defeating the enemy in life. Now, so we must understand, this issue of multiplying is too important. This issue of increase is too important. I listened to the great servant of God, Dr. Kenneth Copeland, or Reverend Kenneth Copeland, some years ago. And he said the first dealing of God with humanity was for him to bless them, be fruitful and multiply. Place your hands on your chest again and declare, I am fruitful and I multiply. I am fruitful and I multiply. I am fruitful and I multiply. Now, so we have now seen some situations. Because since the fall of man took place, the devil has been able to engineer and establish certain structures that make the natural efforts of life not to be productive in certain instances. Why? Because when God said unto Adam and Eve, be fruitful and multiply, if they should come together as a husband and a wife, nothing will stop them from, will stop the woman from getting pregnant. But since the fall of man, the devil has succeeded at establishing some structures that came through what is called curses in life. A curse is a supernatural, a negative supernatural force that holds to ransom. Please pay attention to this definition I'm giving. A curse is a negative supernatural force, power or energy of the devil that holds to ransom the natural means to victory and success, the natural means to result. So what am I trying to say? The natural means to a woman getting pregnant is for the husband to sleep with her. The natural means to somebody succeeding financially is for him to work, get a job, and as he was working on the job or does business, is going to be translating into profit for him. The natural means to succeeding academically is for somebody to go to school, exert energy of listening and practicing the things, reading up the things he has learned, being diligent, then it translates into results in life. But I will tell you the truth. I know people who are serious academically, but they keep failing. So a curse followed the fall of man, and the Bible tells us in Galatians 3 that even before the blessing of Abraham can come upon the Gentiles, Jesus needed to deal first of all with the curse. So many times, a lot of people are expecting the manifestation of the blessing of God upon their life when they are still battling with a measure of curse that they have not dealt with. Now, two means to deal with this, either by the anointing or by their faith in the word of God. Now listen, there are some times that people don't have the faith. The Bible says God will avenge his own elect speedily, who call upon him day and night. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on the earth? Now, so many people may not have the power of faith that is strong enough to overcome the challenge of the curse that they are facing. Is it possible? Peter attempted to walk on water and he began to sink after some time. Then Jesus Christ said, O ye of little faith. In other words, that kind of faith that Peter was holding was not enough to start a project and complete it. Somewhere along the line, he's going to doubt. Somewhere along the line, he's going to fail. Now, having understood that, the other means to overcoming the curse will be by the anointing. And that is the reason God has called servants of God and anointed them. So they could place hands on people, they could pray for people, they could make declarations on people, and the yokes of the enemy, the shackles of the devil will be getting broken from their lives. Isaiah 61, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach the good news unto the poor, to open the gate of prison unto them that are bound, to set the captives free, to comfort those who mourn in Zion, to appoint unto those that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the hall of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, to declare the day of vengeance of our God and the acceptable year of our God. The Bible says, and so that they can be called trees of righteousness and the plantings of the Lord, then they shall rise up and begin to build the old ruins. Now, in other words, the blessing of God will now begin to show up in their lives. But then we must understand it. In fact, let me show us that Galatians chapter 3. We'll soon go to Isaiah 54. Dealing with a curse in life requires just two things. One, either of the two. If you can stand your ground on the promises of God that declares that curses are done away with in your life, in a little time, those curses are going to give up.
they are going to, they can't stand it, the resistance that is being put up when somebody is in faith. And the other option is for the anointed to use the anointing against that curse in your life. But listen to what I want to show you, that is very important. There is a sequence in the order of operation of Jesus setting to bring the blessing of Abraham upon humanity, especially the ones that have given their lives to Jesus. The Bible says in verse 13, Galatians chapter 3, Christ had redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. That is the first stage. Listen, I say it, that is the first stage of what Jesus did. And like I mentioned earlier, Jesus died first before he was raised from the dead. So the dying of Jesus is the measure that took care of curses. And the resurrection of Jesus is the means by which he brought the blessing of Abraham upon the Gentiles. Let me read verse 14 now, which is the second stage. It says that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles. Now, what is that supposed to mean? Is it that the blessing of Abraham? That simply means Jesus took care of curses, first of all, to make way for the blessing of Abraham. So if he didn't deal with curses, there was no way he could make way. It would have been impossible for him to make way for the manifestation of the blessing of Abraham. Until a believer understands this, he may be struggling to get the blessing of Abraham to manifest in his life. But he must first of all identify, this looks like a curse in my life. Let me deal with it. Now, the Bible says Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. So it's not something that the believer on his own is going to make an attempt to deal with. You're attempting to deal with curses is not just to get rid of the curses, but to enforce what Christ has done. And listen, if the anointed is even going to break the yoke in your life, it's going to bring a fact against the devil and against whatever demon is trying to still place the curse on you, enforce it, trying to give reason and facts to those demonic powers, and backing is backed up with the authority of the anointing to push them away. So whether or not they want it, they must leave. Now, if you are going to stand on the word of God, for instance now, and you say in this place that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, you are bringing a fact to whatever demonic force that is responsible for the manifestation of a curse in your life. The reason why it shouldn't be so. And so once he knows that you know your rights, and you're enforcing it with your faith in God, there is no such demon that can stay. Such demon would definitely have to live your life. Now listen, the moment you have overcome that now, the blessing of Abraham will now begin to show up. Let me give a very good example. They said a lady, Christian lady, bedwets, somebody of 26 years of age, 27 years of age, bedwets. That is absurd. That is not normal. It's not supposed to be so. And I will tell you, that is a type of curse. Now listen, she's still bedwetting at 26, 27. A man approaches her. I love you. I want to marry you. So. And by the time he tells the man, I have this problem, the man reconsiders his stance and position, feels that it's not worth it. I can't afford to marry somebody that is bedwetting. Now listen, the man coming into her life is the blessing of Abraham. Now, God wants her to marry. And listen, serially it has happened. About 7 men have come and gone, saying they were sorry, they couldn't go ahead. So, as long as the curse was still in manifestation, she kept missing the blessing of Abraham. So, the order by which Jesus does his work is to first of all take care of the curses and then make the blessing of Abraham to manifest. It will be stupid on the part of the girl to be saying, Lord, give me my own husband without dealing with the problem. It's absolute stupidity. It's absolute foolishness. Why not go and deal with the issue first of all? Now, by the time you are free from that, I am so sure the first man that comes will not say he has a reason to go. If you tell the man, in my past, I used to bed wet, but God has done it in the past 2 years now, the same problem has not shown up. And it was every day of my life that I was bedwetting before. And the man said, what a great thing God has done. This is the right person for me to marry. So the blessing of Abraham cannot be stopped from manifesting by any cause in that regard. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So
Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on the tree. Verse 14, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. What led me to this? I've started talking about curses here because I said as a result of the fall of man, curses were introduced. As a matter of fact, a curse, like I defined it before, I can as well say is one of the manifestations of the death that came with sin when man disobeyed God. The Bible says, through one man's disobedience, sin has entered in the world and death with sin. So a curse is one of the manifestations. And at this juncture, I would like to quickly explain this. In spite of the fact that man fell through Adam and Eve in the garden, and they brought miserability upon the entire humanity by their fall. Psalm 35, I guess, says, the heavens of the heavens belong to God, but the earth he has given unto the sons of men. That simply tells you something. As much as mankind may have sold authority, or Adam and Eve sold authority to Satan, there is still another dimension of the fact that every human being still stands the chance of allowing or disallowing the devil from showing up again. It was Adam and Eve that permitted sin and death by sin into the world. But listen to me, in certain families, some kind of evils have been permitted by people in authority in such homes as well. And that is what gave birth to generational curse of different dimensions. For instance, now, upon the entire humanity, the generational curse of the entrance of sin and death came through Adam. There is nobody, as long as you are human, you are going to partake of that until you are redeemed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. But different homes now, in different nations, for one reason or the other, may have some peculiar introduction of the devil that does not apply to another one. I give you a very good example. You can have two Christian families living in the same neighborhood. In fact, their houses are beside each other. But in the lineage of a particular one, there is a generational curse that is ravaging them. In the other family, they don't have such. And as such, these ones, they go to the same church, they do about the same things together, but this evil that somebody in their lineage permitted is ravaging them, but it's not happening to the other one. So, as it has to be peculiar with them, whoever in that family that had authority, just like Adam and Eve, excuse me, hallelujah, just like Adam and Eve had authority, whoever in that family that brought about the entrance of that evil, brought it into that lineage simply, it could not affect these other ones. These ones are from Edo, these ones are from Oyo. Even if the two of them are from Edo, they may come from two different families and lineage that will not allow it to bounce on the head of these ones. So it's very important. We must not be assuming. As much as I believe that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, there are things to do so that those curses will not be manifestation again. Please pay attention, I beg you, in the name of the Lord. There is a measure of laziness on the part of the child of God and a measure of lack of cooperation with God on the part of the child of God that makes the devil look like he's powerful. But really, it is not the power of the devil that we are fighting against as believers. What can we be fighting against? We are only fighting against the recalcitrance of the devil. A situation where he's trying to force on us things that don't legally belong to us again. As much as Jesus Christ redeemed us from sicknesses, for instance, why is it that headaches comes to our head? Why is it that cold and catarrh attack us? It's not just an automatic thing that because Christ did it, is an auto condition. It will just be happening without us doing anything. that he's the devil that knows that truly, truly Jesus has taken our infirmity, but still wants to offer us the same infirmity. And when he brings it against us now, what is expected of us believers is to put up the facts and the reasons why they shouldn't stand, they shouldn't be on us against that devil. Then he packs his things and goes away. Listen, he did not spare the Lord Jesus Christ. He used the hunger that Jesus went through in the wilderness. He used it to make him to fall. And so he's not going to spare you. He's going to bring a lot of things against you to discourage you in life. And if you agree to him by being lazy or by not knowing and understanding enough the position of God for your deliverance, then he continues to oppress you. And there are too many believers now that are so confused by that position that they will conclude that the devil is powerful. Now, let's go back to the book of Isaiah 54. This is the reason I've been sharing everything I'm sharing all this while. And from this Isaiah 54, I'm going to show us an example of somebody. Hallelujah. I'll show us an example of someone that, blessed be God. I'll show us an example of somebody that has gone through the experience I told us about now. Isaiah 54, if somebody can read for me from verse 1. Isaiah 54, blessed be God. Let me take it myself. The single old barren. Can you see? I told us the reason why people can be barren in life. This barren woman here, is it that the husband was not sleeping with her? No, the husband was sleeping with her regularly. But why was she still barren? Because sin and death came upon humanity and the devil engineered certain things. Single barren, thou that didst not bear, bring forth into singing and cry aloud. Thou that didst not travail with child, for more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife, saith the Lord. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thine habitations. Spare not, lengthen thy cords and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame, for thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood anymore. Now look at me, everybody here. I said when I began to read this passage that this woman was not barren because she didn't have a husband to sleep with her. The husband did the needful, yet she wasn't pregnant. But don't forget, I said originally as well, God blessed humanity, be fruitful and multiply. And that was before the fall of man. Eventually mankind fell and the devil was able to introduce curses into the destiny of humanity. Let me tell you again the definition of curse. Like I said, is a supernatural force, energy, power introduced by the devil into a human life to make every natural process that makes for productivity, increase, and fruitfulness to fail. A supernatural power, strength, force, and energy introduced into human life by the devil to make every natural means to fruitfulness, increase, productivity to fail. So now listen, the natural means to getting pregnant is for the husband to sleep with the wife. If there is a curse somewhere, it will fail. The natural means to succeeding academically is to be diligent. If there is a curse there, it will fail. The natural means to increasing financially is to get a job, to be involved with something that is productive, and to be diligent with it. But if there is a curse, it will fail. But then,
Is that going to be the end of the life of the child of God?
No.
So we see this woman here, that the natural means to productivity has failed because there is a curse. Suddenly God decided to mercifully intervene in a matter and case, and God showed up, and God began to give her certain instruction so that her story would change. Now listen to me. It doesn't matter how bad things are with the person. It doesn't matter how bad things are with someone. It doesn't matter the level of the curse that is manifesting in the life of a believer. I tell you a truth, God can bring about a change. The yoke can be destroyed. Now listen, I've said today to magnify curses. But I'm letting us know that there is a devil that is wicked somewhere and want to offer you what does not belong to you. And as a matter of fact, if a curse is still showing up in your life as a child of God, it could be either of two. It can be one of three things. You are careless enough to have allowed the curse. Number two, you are not putting up enough resistance. And number three, you probably are in a position of patience, waiting for the manifestation of the result of your faith. Now listen, the three positions I've said will define anybody. Now, so if you are living a careless life, then you must now know that you must become active and shut the door against him. If you know you have been lazy as a child of God, hallelujah. On the phone? Hallelujah. If you're a child of God, what is that? It's simply what you do. You must just decide that you are going to be obedient henceforth. Stand up actively against the devil. It still goes a lot. Hallelujah. Number three. If you are doing all you are supposed to be doing and the manifestation hasn't come, don't bother. Bible says, let patience have its perfect work. So as you have been patient, standing in the on the word of God, the devil's back is going to be broken, and it will be the one to yield to you, and it will be the one to surrender and let you have your way. Blessed be God. Blessed be God. So this woman here, God showed up for her, and God began to give her certain instructions. But like I said last Sunday, the instruction God gave this woman is to create room for the power of God to work in her life. And that is why I'm not joking with this, and I'm telling us to be more diligent and more serious with our spirit life. Galatians 5:25. Since this is the kind of life that we have chosen, the life of the spirit, let's not just hold it as a mere idea in our head, nor a sentiment in our heart, but work out its implication in every detail of our lives. That is extremely significant. You must make up your mind that you are not just going to be blabbing that you have the Spirit of God. The results of that spirit life must show up in your life. Does God bypass by his energy, by his spirit, a natural order to still bring about the increase, the fruitfulness that he has blessed mankind with? Yes. I begin to round off from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 1 from verse 26. We are going to see this very powerful story here of how God bypassed the natural order of life and still did what he wants to do. I don't care what may be wrong with you. Somebody is medically impotent and God says you are going to have a child. It will not matter if you are still impotent. You can have that child. Somebody's uterus is perforated, and the doctors and medical personnel says she doesn't stand the chance of doing well or of getting pregnant again. It will not matter. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. If the uterus is perforated, there is a God that bypasses a broken uterus to do what he wants to do. Somebody does not have enough money for an advantage in life, and without such money, he can't get the advantage. There is a God that bypasses that. Now, let's look at the book of Luke chapter 1, verse 26. But before you begin to have these dimensions
of experience. You must have made room for God, just like the woman in Isaiah 54 was instructed to make room for God. Verse 26, and in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth. Today is Easter. One of the things I hate is religion, unscriptural religion. Religion is one of the reasons that will make you to be involved with people, with other believers. They are victorious, you are not victorious. They are doing well, you are not doing well. They have testimonies, you don't have testimonies, and you still continue with them. You must ask questions. If you are not going to be a religious believer, you must not just push your conscience aside and just continue to do things. Listen, God displayed to us in the parable in Luke 13 that he hates unfruitfulness and he doesn't commit to unfruitfulness. He said the kingdom of God is like a owner of a vineyard that appointed a husbandman. And after 3 years, he came and he asked for the harvest of the different trees. And a particular tree was there that did not bear fruit. And the owner of the vineyard said, these 3 years, this tree has occupied ground. It has taken nutrients, but it has not produced fruit for us. Then he told the husbandman or the farmer or the gardener that he hired, cut it down. So that simply means we must know that, we must have that attitude of God, that if something is not bringing results, it's not worth maintaining. I'm not saying you should go and throw away your faith. You are the one that has the challenge, but you must query what is wrong about yourself, that you are not producing the kind of results that you should be producing. God has never been wrong. It will be us that will be wrong. But why will it not be better for you to query what may be wrong and let God open your eyes and you do the needful and then you overcome? So when the Easter period, you must ensure that results come out of your life. Everything Jesus did for us, we are celebrating. Now listen, can you pointedly show the manifestation of those things that Jesus did? Your body is full of sickness for the past 20 years. They are still there. Then what did Jesus do? You are moving from death to death and it doesn't look like it's getting better. Then what did Jesus do? You don't seem to have a sign of progress in your life. No favor from any quarters. What did Jesus do? And does it mean Jesus didn't do anything? Jesus did everything. But you are the one that must rise up and find out, what am I doing wrong here? As you celebrate Easter now, you will just be holding the sweet life as a sentiment in your heart when you just celebrate it without quantifiably identifying the real reason in your life. So I go back to Luke 1:26. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive. Now I want us to pay very close attention. Then behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. And he shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? I've told us natural processes. God blessed them and Eve, and they had to sleep together before Eve could get pregnant and they would begin to have children. Listen to me. That is a natural process. So When the angel appeared to Mary and told her that she was going to have a child, she was asking, how is that going to be possible without the natural process in place? Now listen, for those of you that maybe have been doing things by the natural process, but a curse of the other is not allowing it to show, I bring you solution right now. Next verse. And the angel said unto her, I love this so much. And the angel answered and said unto her, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Let me tell you something. Where there is no natural process to bring a result, the Holy Ghost can take the place and bring about changes. Now listen, I'm not going to stop there. Let me show you two miracles happen in this chapter. Verse 36, and behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her, who is called barren. Now listen, in her old age, this woman has passed menopause, but yet the angel said she has also conceived. So Mary conceived without a human, without a man sleeping with her, because the power of God came upon her. The Spirit of God enveloped her. And Elizabeth, even though the husband slept with her, she shouldn't have gotten pregnant because she was past menopause. But the same thing that made Mary to conceive came upon Elizabeth as well, and she also got pregnant. Let me tell you something. If there's anybody watching me today and you are called barren, listen, it doesn't matter. Listen, it is not the high sperm count. The sperm count doesn't need to improve. But there is the anointing of the Spirit that does the job. If Mary, if Elizabeth didn't go back to menstruation before she could eventually conceive, then nobody needs a boost in sperm count before there can be conception. Listen, it doesn't matter if the uterus has been removed. If Mary didn't have a man sleeping with her and she got pregnant because the Holy Ghost enveloped her, then with or without the uterus, a woman can still get pregnant. Ladies and gentlemen, these are dimensions of the Spirit. The Bible says, single barren. And wherever you are, I want you to rise up on your feet. Taking this message by faith today, and I want you to begin to sing. Especially if you have identified that something is not working fine in your life. This is going to be your action of faith. God instructed the woman, single barren, rejoice she that has not born. So if you have not given birth to a result you desire in life, rejoice like the word of God says. So let's rise up on our feet and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Particularly for this instruction, the Bible says, single barren, thou that didst not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud. I want you to begin to sing unto the Lord. My soul doth magnify the Lord. Instead of allowing the pressure of the enemy to weigh you down, do what the Bible instructs here. And my spirit praise his name. What is the secret? There is the power of the Almighty. There is the Holy Ghost that can overshadow anybody and brings a result that naturality may not be able to produce. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. Oh, my soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit praise his name. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is the Lord. Bless him, bless him, bless him. Lima Zatayan Lord. As you bless him, you begin to receive grace for multiplication, for increase, and for a life beyond the impossible. The power of the Almighty will begin to come upon you, and the glory of the Almighty will overshadow you. Lebra hega zeto yande brohebidesia. Kabale ezanto no moko buga. Able heve zeto na nikabuya televika hasha. Lembre heve zeto ya dibla haka maza. Embro hogo zoto ya dika kaga. Lambro hovo duzo zuzo 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 zuzo. Lembro hovo duzo zuzo zuzo vina. Lembro hovo duzo zia. He says the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. I see that grace, that anointing, lemazia, descending on somebody. Lemazeko talive gedia. Abramaza tuna nivikete yadaba. Worship it, worship it. Yela muzatina mokaba. Lamazia tuna. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. Lord, for death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. I don't care what has not been working in your life, begin to receive the power of the Spirit coming upon you and the glory of the Lord overshadowing you. Lima Zatoya, as you worship it. Lima Zia, something beyond the natural order, something beyond the normal. Lima Zia, something that overtakes curses. Lima Zia Tulabe, Emble Hebe Zia Kasataya. Upon your academics, receive the glory of the Almighty. Lema jana namba yate ble hise tuya emprohovo zotuya upon your business, upon your finances, especially in places that we have made necessary efforts, but it has not translated. The power of God has come to accompany you, lema zatea, and partner with you, lema zato nagia, lepre hevesia, so that you will get resolved when it is not expected of you to get resolved. Lema zeto yadaba, ena moso kuyadaba, the things that you have written off, lema zato ya, because Elizabeth has written everything herself off. The Bible says in our old age, let me see, the people that the things that people have used to tag you, because she that was called the barren, let me say to Nani Kea, if you have been called the poor in your family, they've called you the poor, but you are not poor in Christ. The Bible says, behold the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that you through his poverty might become rich. Let me say to Nani Kea, let me say, I see touch tags changing. Let me say to Davia, the barren has been called the fruit. Let me see to there. The poor will be called the rich. You receive grace. Let me say, for such experiences, the same people that call you this will now begin to call you the other. Let me say to Yande Brehaven Desiala. The same people that call you failure will now begin to call you success. As this power of the Almighty, let me see Tayadaba. Grace, let me see, begins to land on you. Leka Dosia and Brehajanana Klahukazia. Yende Blehese to ya. Even the dimensions that makes the efforts of Jesus to be real. Even the dimensions that make the sacrifices of Jesus to be real in the believer's life. Leka dukabia, am sotono nugagaya, apre ese to lakabaya tali vedizia, em jeno kabefe solabatia, for death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord, for death could not hold him captive, even in the grave. Jesus is Lord. Libra Havadasia, shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the works of your hand. Forever I love you, forever I stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have in you. Blessing, 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 blessing. Nagela geso to ya daba susuluma na hantia. Libra have zika bashi tula biga dada. Ambre mese tuna biga bola. Asa digaga leso tuna nakia. Andre bevezuketa labadi vidu silaba. Embro hosa tu ya deka bashua. Lord Losiata, yeah. Just bless him. We're honoring, we're worshiping him. Lim is it to, yeah. He says, single barren. If you know a change is coming into your life, you will bless the Lord. Yene Maziato Nabia and your different homes there, bless the Lord. Lim is here. You don't feel like lifting your hands, lift them up and bless him. Lim Mazia. You don't feel like singing. The Bible says, bring forth into singing and cry aloud. Lim is here. Don't make it a whisper. Cry it aloud. Lim is here to, yeah. For what your natural effort cannot do, the Holy Ghost is coming upon you to get done. Lim I speak to the children and to the student that has been outraged to begin to come to the front. Because the word of God says, you shall be the head and not the tail. I speak to the one that has been looking for the fruit of the womb to begin to receive it, because the anointing to get people, Lemezia, to be fruitful, Lemezia, is available right now. The anointing that breaks the spine of any kind of curse. Is only natural things that causes can suppress. It's only natural efforts that causes can suppress. They cannot handle anything that is supernatural of God. Let me say, no curse can handle anything that is supernatural of God. The Bible says the anointing came upon Elijah and he outran the king's chariot. That is what the anointing can do. That is what the Spirit of God can do when it comes upon a man. I begin to speak to failing business now to begin to rise up. Stagnant businesses to begin to rise up. As you worship the Master. In Jesus' name, I pray. Listen to this. If somebody is struggling academically, and this is his or her record, and is a believer, if it is possible that they say that status of academics, she's always coming last in class, and they now replace with a believer that is blessed, and they say run the same academic program that this person has been running for the next one time. Read the same way she's reading. Go about things the way she does it. She reads at night, you read at night. She reads about 2 hours every night. You read 2 hours every night. Use her style, use everything. If the new person they said should do it for a time has this glory dimension upon her, the same person will come first in class. So it is not the effort, it is the lack of a thing. If somebody is struggling in business now, and they invite somebody that has this dimension upon him, take his or her business at the level it is now. Deal with the same customers he or she is dealing with. Go about the same business the same way he's going about it. And let's check it for 3 months. The one that has this dimension upon him will get results. So we're talking about, it is not the effort, it is the dimension that is upon the man. And listen, when the same dimension comes upon the one that has been failing, he will now begin to succeed. Lift up your hand and begin to say, Lord, I receive this dimension of the glory of God, these dimensions of the supernatural energy and abilities of the Spirit, this dimension that surpasses, that bypasses the natural order to bring fruitfulness and to bring results. I receive in the name of, lift up your hands and begin to claim and begin to say, you receive. I said, lift up your hands and begin to receive. Is a posture of surrenderedness before the Master. If the devil can bring his power on people and their little physical effort is fetching result, how much more God? The whole powerful God I receive. The same dimensions that open doors that are shut, and that opens everlasting doors, the same dimension that curry favor,
The same dimension that is rightly led, leka zato no mofunina, embremezetu na kekolosta, embremejana na galohosia, embremezetu na viakula, emblehevezetu ya debrohovozoto ya debrehiki zato, anavala kazata na moshika, yende blehezetu ya debrahava zaka moka, ela sanda buba hafa swalabatia. Jesus, we give you glory. Father, we bless you. I want you to place your hair and on your right hand on your head. I want to just make some proclamations upon you. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for the lives of your people, and thank you because of this wonderful opportunity to receive this dimension of your grace upon us. As many as are listening to me and believes in this dimension and are putting their hands on their head right now, I ask for a sealing of this upon their head, upon their lives, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let struggles end in the name of Jesus. Amen. And for the curses that have been broken, in fact, I declare, let any curse that is stopping the natural order, natural effort from working, that is frustrating the attempts they are putting into life, let it be broken right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. And I say, I pave way for the manifestation of the blessing of Abraham. Amen. In their lives, in the name of Jesus. Amen. From now on, beautiful experiences will be yours. Amen. The devil is silenced against you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. The places where doors have been shut against you, they will be opened in the name of Jesus. Amen. The different frustrations you keep experiencing is over today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we give you glory. Let your financial life change. Amen. Let improvement come to it. Amen. Let the demons governing them leave and let angels take their place in the name of Jesus. It is well with us. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. I want to go about this week rejoicing, believing that you have received the dimension of grace. Curses are no longer yours, and curses are taken away from your life, and now there can be a manifestation of the blessing of Abraham in your life. In Jesus' name we have prayed. God bless us. It's time for us to worship the Lord with our offerings. Let me pray. Anybody that may be sick one way or the other, I want to pray for you. I command right now, let the power of God hit you wherever you are. As I stretch my hand, let the virtue of God go through the hand to you as you behold in the name of Jesus. I say, let the power of God hit you from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Be healed completely in the name of Jesus. Be healed completely in the name of Jesus. Be healed completely in the name of Jesus. It is well with you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you because of this. Bring out your offerings. Father, we thank you because of this wonderful opportunity to honor you with our offerings again today. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for giving us this seed to sow. You are the one that ministers seed to the sower and bread to the eater and multiply the seed sown and increase the fruit of righteousness. Lord, let all these dimensions happen to us again in the name of Jesus. Be delighted in your heart because we are worshiping with our offerings in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Let's do that quickly. If they don't extend the deadlock by the grace of God on Wednesday, we're going to meet in church. We're going to be having a wonderful time in the presence of God. Don't forget the tips I gave us last Sunday as means to increasing the capacity for the Holy Ghost to fill in our lives. I told us, number one, and I hope we should not lose concentration. Listen to me. I told us, number one, we should listen to the preachings of the Word of God ardently. Number two, we should pray in tongues like crazy. Number three, we should maintain fellowship with people who are spirit-filled. And number four, we should fast anything that is going to militate against our spiritual development. Hallelujah. It's time for us to give our tithe. Anybody that has tithe, let me just pray for tithers here. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for the lives of these ones that are paying their tithes in their different places they are high. Hey, I ask, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, that this tithe of theirs will be acceptable before you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I say on your behalf, as the high priest after the order of Melchizedek, I say let there be an empowering of the promises of yours for the lives of these people. Everything you've promised them, as they begin to expect it and work it, the blessing dimension will come upon it and it's going to turn into results in the name of Jesus. Amen. I rebuke the devourer for your sakes. The devil will not partake of the things of God for you in the mighty name of Jesus. It is well with everyone. For Jesus' name we've prayed. Let's share the grace. Oh, before we share the grace, let me just speak to somebody that is watching us via Facebook or YouTube. This is the Safe Havens Christian Church. We are broadcasting Happy Home Church because of the lockdown that is taking place in the nation. And I hope that you've had a wonderful time fellowshipping with us if this is your first time. So we'd like to just tell you that the ministry is based in Oshogbo, Osun State, Nigeria. And you can always get us on Facebook. So if you care to know more about us, you can send a message and we'll always reply you back. Hallelujah. Amen. Time. Okay. Who's giving paint time?
Online time.
Online time. Works. Hallelujah. So let's share the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost is with us now and forevermore. In Jesus' name. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercies are following us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.